third plenary session of the 11th Chinese National People's Congress came to a close Sunday at the Great Hall of the People in Beijing. The Chinese House of Parliament passed 8 items, including a work report by the State Council and a draft amendment to the electoral law on the last day of its proceedings. After the closing ceremony, Chinese Premier Wen Jiabao fielded questions from local and foreign media at a meet-the-press session. Wen touches on several major issues, such as social injustice, China's foreign currency policy, and the tense China-US relations. He says social and judicial injustice are still prevalent in China, but his government is doing all it can to create a fair and just living environment for everyone. Responding to a question on some foreign investors' sentiments that the business environment in China is not as conducive as before, the Premier reiterates that the inflow of foreign investment to China is still picking up. China has been a target of the international community, especially the United States, in the debate of China's foreign currency policy. These countries mount the pressure on the Chinese to appreciate the yuan and claim that the yuan is kept undervalued, giving Chinese exporters an unfair price advantage.
Chinese 其中有十六个国家对中国的出口是增长的，就是先生所在的欧盟地区出口总体下降20.3%，但是对中国的出口只下降15.3%。
He says last year Germany's exports to China reached 76 billion euro, which was the highest in its history. And of the 17% decline in the U.S. exports to the world, its exports to China only decreased by 2.2%.
在国际金融危机爆发和蔓延期间，人民币汇率保持基本稳定，对世界经济复苏做出了重要贡献。人民币汇率机制改革是从2005年七月份开始的，到现在，人民币的币值对美元升值21%，实际有效汇率升值16%。我这里特别强调指出，就是2008年七月到2009年二月，也就是世界经济极为困难的时期，人民币并没有升啊，并没有贬值，而实际有效汇率升值14.5%。人民币将继续坚持与市场供求啊为目的啊，以市场供求为目的，这个有管理的浮动汇率制度，我们将进一步推进人民币汇率形成机制的改革，保持人民币汇率在合理均衡水平上的基本稳定。
Wen also says the recent arms sales to Taiwan and Dalai Lama's visit to the U.S. have jeopardized the China-U.S. relations, but he still harbors high hopes that the relationship between the two countries will improve.
奥巴马总统入主拜登以后，中美关系有个良好的开端，但是最近一个时期，美方在达赖啊喇嘛访美和对台军售等问题上，触犯了中国的主权和领土完整，使中美关系受到严重的干扰，这个责任不在中国，而在美方。我曾经讲过，中美建交30年的历史告诉我们，合则两利，斗则俱伤。互信，则进；财进，则退。对话比对抗好，合作比遏制好，伙伴比对手好。
As for China's economic growth, the Premier says the country is still developing, with its central and western regions still lagging behind. It will take some 50 years for China to attain the status of a moderately developed country, and probably a century to become a full-fledged developed nation. From Beijing, Chao Haoban, The Star, Malaysia.